Hi, I'm Joe Griffel. Welcome to It's Your Voice, where Senator Mike Ranzenhofer is joining us to talk to the 61st District constituents. Senator Ranzenhofer, welcome back to Albany.
Well, it's great to be back and settle in for another year of a lot of interesting issues this year.
Well, you kick it off very early with the State of the State. Right. As the year starts, you get the State of the State message, and that's followed by the budget message. So why don't you share with us and your constituents some of your perspective of some of the initiatives that have been proposed?
Well, this is, again, this is a hodgepodge of different ideas. The one thing that I'm focused in on is tax relief, and I'm glad that the governor, both in the State of the State and his budget message, is finally, after a number of years, getting a little bit more serious about tax relief. He's proposed the elimination of the energy tax, which I fought for very hard last year, and looks like this year we're going to be able to get rid of the energy tax. We want to make sure that those income tax cuts are still in place. We want to make permanent the property tax cap that's been in place for a number of years. And there are a number of tax reductions for small business and manufacturers as well, which we really need to implement in this year's budget. So my job is to make sure and just fight very hard that those tax decreases that are mentioned in the budget stay in the budget, because there are other people that just want to spend that money. And I want to fight to make sure that the people receive those tax cuts that are in the budget.
So you would say that the budget, as presented, controls spending, cuts taxes, and invests in economic opportunity, which is really what you have been advocating in your conference over the last couple of years. Many of the programs you've talked about, the governor's included, along with a property tax freeze.
Right.
How is that being received? Because I know that's tied into initiatives by the local governments also.
There's positives and negatives. I mean, I don't necessarily like tying an individual's property tax freeze into what happens in his or her town. So that's something that we got to look at very carefully. I mean, I'm going to encourage and have encouraged, all the local governments to do all that they can to live within the same type of property tax cap that we have imposed upon ourselves in state government for the last couple of years. But there, I don't want to see anybody penalized because if a town government or village government, doesn't abide by that cap. Most of the towns and villages and cities that I represent have done a good job of staying within the cap. And I want to make sure that, the overburdened taxpayer, receives that property tax relief that they really need.
So your focus will be on all of the tax reform package. You also have been talking about regulatory relief for businesses and mandate relief for local governments, and that will also be a priority?
And so it's been a priority, and the difficulty that we've had is getting those through the Assembly. The Senate has done a very, very good job of conducting hearings and talking to constituents, and I'm out there all the time, and I hear from business folks all the time about the type of mandate relief and regulatory relief that they need. We just have to, keep our foot on the gas pedal and fight very hard to make sure that it's included in the budget. The governor did not include it in his budget. There's a tremendous package there that is out there for consideration. So I'm going to fight very hard with my colleagues to make sure that we can get all or most of that that package in there.
One of the other significant and probably noteworthy initiatives and discussions is on education. I know you sit on the education committee.
Right.
Many of your constituents have expressed their concerns and objections to the Common Core as it's been rolled out. Where is that now? I know the governor talked about it, but where do you stand and what do you think the Senate will do this year?
Yeah, well, serving on the education committee, I've heard a lot. I think because of my position, a lot of folks come to me on that particular issue in Western New York. And there's three proposals that are out there. One is to just abolish it entirely. The second is to have a moratorium for 1, 2, or 3 years. I've introduced a bill or a series of bills, four bills, which will address some of the concerns that I've heard as I travel throughout the community, which is testing, which is privacy, and a number of other issues that people are very concerned about. So because there are just so many different proposals out there, I want to make sure that something happens this year. I mean, I would like to see, a lot stronger proposal than some other folks. But at the end of the day, I want to make sure that we get something done to give the type of relief that parents and kids and teachers have been asking for since this has been rolled out.
Your general feeling, the governor outlined his funding for education. It's within the 4% to increase, but I know you and your colleagues are looking at a lot of components to that too. He talked about the bond for new technology for schools.
Yeah, there's one of the things when you talk about a 4% increase and then you look at it district by district, you know, every district is treated differently, and all of my school districts have had an opportunity to take a look at what's proposed in this year's budget. Some have fared better than others. So right now we're just having dialogues with all of our different school districts about how the 4% actually translates into the amount of funds that they are going to receive. I think the initiative that the governor has is a nice initiative. I don't know if that's the right way to go. I don't know if we want to increase our indebtedness without making sure that we're paying off some of the indebtedness at the other end. And one of the things you have to look at, I mean, he's talking about money for computers and high tech equipment. You also have to look at the condition of some of the schools. I mean, some of the schools across our state, particularly in the 61st district, are old. And the issue is whether or not we should be putting money into bricks and mortar as opposed to iPads and iPhones and computers and stuff like that. So that's something that I want to take a look at very, very carefully. And certainly, and as I travel throughout the district, you know, want to hear what parents have to say and teachers have to say about that proposal.
Well, we'll have plenty of time over the next couple of weeks to talk more in detail on some of the budget proposals and concepts that the governor advanced in the state of the state. But staying with the school, you had something unique in Williamsville that you want to talk about, right? A space element?
Yeah, it's very, very interesting. One of our local high schools in the Williamsville Central School District, they have a space lab planetarium, which was in dire need of repair. So I was able to secure funding in order to essentially rebuild that planetarium that was falling apart. Not only is it a great asset to the kids that go to the Williamsville School District, but about 20,000 people a year go through that. So it's more of a regional asset. Kids from all across Western New York are able to go in there and really, to explore and discover about space. And I think it really develops the curiosity and, you know, just the type of things that we want kids to do. We want them to learn. We want them to be curious. And just on a side note, I remember when my son, who was 4 years old, before he was even in school, he went to that space lab planetarium on a school field trip. And, it's good to see that, 25, 30 years later, that we're able to refurbish this, and it's now state of the art, and they'll probably be getting even more than the 20,000 annual that they've had over the last couple of years. So it was good to see. It was a very good event, and very, very excited about that.
And I would think that's very significant, considering that there's limited resources for projects like that, as worthy as they may be across the state.
Yeah, there's hundreds and hundreds of worthy projects, and one of the things that you want to make sure is that it really is going to benefit the students. And the feedback that I've had from the folks in the school district are just it's just great. It's the kids love it.
Well, the hearings will start next week, and you'll have an opportunity to hear from your constituents and from various segments across the state.
Right.
So we'll look forward to talking to you in a couple of weeks to go into detail and examine some of the finer aspects of the budget proposals and the governor's initiatives.
Yeah, we're just in the first inning right now, and it's going to be a long several months until we finally, arrive at a final budget.
And an on-time budget?
I don't make predictions, but that would be my goal.
So, you heard it from Senator Mike Ranzenhofer. We appreciate him coming to speak to the constituents of the 61st District. So, this has been your voice. Thank you, Senator Mike Ranzenhofer.
Great to be here.
We'll see you next time.
Great to be here.